Still busy scratching her head.
Okay, good afternoon, students. So, today we'll be learning about prepositions. We'll be using the silent way approach to learn this topic. Okay, now let's look at the objective. The first objective is student will be able to construct sentences by using prepositions. And the second one is student will be able to apply their previous knowledge in constructing sentences. Okay, so can someone tell me what you have learned in the previous lesson?
Adverb.
Okay, this one we will learn the next lesson.
Wow. Okay, teacher.
Okay, good. Okay, article. Article, we learn a and the. Okay, good. Okay, before I start the lesson, I would like to introduce the classroom rules. Okay. The first one. Be silent when the teacher is teaching. The second one. Reply when the teacher shows the hand gesture. Then the third one is do not play while the teacher is teaching. So now I'll point the words and I'll ask someone to read up.
In a box.
Cup. Cup is cup the cup is under the table.
Cupcake in front of the white box. Bakery. Ping pong.
Ball.
Ping pong.
Ball.
It's a ball.
Ping pong ball.
Ping pong.
Oh. You're all right.
Box.
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 Cup.
Wait.
Ball.
Wait.
Ah. The ball is in front of the box.
Scissors.
A pair of scissors.
Oh, a pair of scissors.
Oh yeah.
Butterfly. Pin, it's a hairpin. Inside the cup.
Drop in the cup. Okay. In.
The pin is inside the cup.
In the cup. In the cup.
Ruler. Ruler is in the cup.
Ruler is in the cup.
Okay, so now it's pair-work discussion. Okay, so now I'll give you this worksheet. So you have to work in pairs to construct 5 sentences using prepositions.
Can be both, right?
The parents are pissed behind the door.
Right, Dr. Lee? The parents are pissed behind the door. Look how dirty the room is.
It's like third wall interaction.
Yeah.
Fat. 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 Fat.
Karena cara kita mungkin sejak kata.
Cikgu,
tapi saya tak ada mana-mana.
Okay, so you have 30 seconds. Okay, so now I'll go around and collect your paper. Basically, the students were getting involved in their teaching, so they were basically learning by themselves. So that's why he said, involve me and we learn better. So that's the handsome guy who has created this approach, Dr. Caleb Garino. So he's an Euro educator from Egypt. So what he says was, when the teachers is being silent, they tend to learn better. Students tend to cognitively be active. So cognitive code approach. They engage in formulating the rules. So when you see just now, the students were like trying to put in on, so they were trying to cognitively think, and they try to engage the rules of the target language. And this is based, the learning is facilitated if the learner discovers. They don't really repeat, but they discovering by themselves. So they discover, they say, okay, the ruler is in the cup. So they discover by themselves, and they don't keep repeating to what the teacher say. I say it's on, so it's not the teacher. The students repeat back. So yeah, it comes with using physical objects. And he also mentioned that teaching is subordinated to learning. So what he meant was, the teachers must be responsive to immediate learning needs. So like for example, just now when there was a word white, and Asma said it with. So the pronunciation was wrong. So it goes back to another friend. It's always a peer correction. So another friend is helping. So it comes back to them and they develop by themselves. So in area of language, for example, we concentrated on the words itself. Some, for the basic one, they go back to the sound chart. For example, this was the sound chart, so they see phonetics learning. So where does it go? So they go start, they use the color chart to actually explore those words. They learn by themselves. So learning is basically inductive, so they learn by themselves. And no linear structural syllabus, they build from what they already know. So like for example, in this class, the situation was the student already know those words. Now they're applying into a sentences. How they construct a sentences using preposition.
So the previous class, they already know. So it's building up on what the students already know. So it consists on all the skills, reading, writing, speaking, and also listening. So these are the samples of silent way approach that they use, the color rod. So for example, in this rod, they explain by, so like for example, the orange and, okay, this is black and red. So they explain by the black pen is on the red pen is on the black one. So that's the way actually they teach. So they're teaching colors and they are teaching the students to actually explore. So like for example, like what I did, so they put inside and they learn in, on, between, front and behind. So now let us have a quick discussion on Q&A session. These three questions, we'll have a group discussion.
Okay, so now we'll work in groups of four. Okay, so,
I don't know, we can go to you. It's here for you guys.
So you all have 5 minutes to discuss.
Let's see what they have to think about how they feel.
something like the how do you explain that in this and how would kids discuss? So like it's no discussion in the country. This has very little. This is like a special service.
Okay, so now let's start our discussion. Okay, so for the first question, who would like to volunteer to answer the first question? Okay,
but
speak.
Okay. So like you feel like one advantage is like students are forced to speak. Because if students don't speak in a silent way, then we cannot move on the lesson. So like you may say like this is like part of forced awareness. So like they are forced to speak, and at the same time they give full attention to the teacher in order to progress through the lesson. So that's one of the advantages.
Yeah, we said
like
the student got more interaction, verbal interaction, which sometimes they speak wrongly, then the student like the teacher will point to another student to help them to assist. Then the second, the disadvantages, who would like to answer? Yes, ma'am?
It doesn't really keep the students' attention, so the teacher is going to be somewhat difficult for the
students. Anyone? Disadvantages?
Share their knowledge with their peers. They can't share what they've learned from each other.
still self-learning.
Learn from their peers or
learning. They don't have the chance to do that.
Then the third question. Do I have the answer, Fatima?
So, I don't think it's effective for all levels of language because it will work for beginners because you are probably using smaller words like on, prepositions, nouns, pronouns, adverbs. But when you go for a higher level, how are you going to explain those words that need more verbal pronunciation? So it probably wouldn't work. And what is this?
Use words for instructions for you, not for answers.
And for improvement, I think you can use more written to give instructions so that students are able to understand better and it's less time consuming rather than acting out the whole instruction. You can just write it easier.
There's a good point that you mentioned at the beginning. It's always for the beginners, yes, and it's more for students. They want to learn another language. So that is good. But when you mentioned that when you written, isn't it like a spoon feeding type of? It's being spoon fed and they tend to write. Do you think?
But then what about a special needs student who is blind?
Yeah.
Okay, even writing won't help, but you have to.
Let's just say that it's like generally very slow.
Yeah. It doesn't accommodate to everyone in the class.
It's true. It doesn't accommodate.
Like, no, we're just trying to like we only use like words when we give instruction, but not when we give answers.
So it's like filling in the blank.
So instruction,
like,
you anyways have to give them. You either act it out or write it. So you'd rather write it.
That's only when it comes
when,
to answers.
Yeah,
so
to
we
answers,
can still
you can
focus
use
on different level of
yeah,
language.
Yeah.
Okay. Good points that has been tried. It is, with this approach, it is very for beginner focus, like what y'all mentioned. It's very for those who are at the very beginning stage. And it's also questionable all the research that it really doesn't show that it's still questionable whether it can go for a higher degree teaching. How can the teacher be scaffolding each other? How can the teacher be acting? And how can the teacher use those objects to actually teach the students in a very silent way? So silent way is basically teachers keeping quiet. It's very, very, it's very time consuming, like what y'all say. It's very, very time consuming. And students tend to get bored as well because it's focused for everyone to think and they have to repeat. Like what Asma said, sometimes it's very, very boring. Good points, Shai.
Understand what you're trying to convey through silent.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, that's a very good question. So it is at the the teacher first, like what we did just now was that one of the students is making a mistake. So and then they move to the next student to help them. So when the next student says the answer, the next student helps. I mean the next friend's is peer correcting. So when the next friend helps, but even if the whole class like couldn't answer, then the teacher would come and say it out. Then like the teacher will be the last after going through each student and getting everyone think then only the last point will be the teacher.
Why would a teacher use this approach?
You need to ask Dr. Caleb Galindo. Yeah, actually yes, it is very, I think when we were looking at the points, it was very suitable for those dumb teachers. There was actually some,
as in dumb that can't speak.
Yeah, those teachers who can't speak.
Okay.
Not those dumb. Okay, they
okay.
can't speak. And the other one is like those teachers who are not very good at English, so they prefer teaching in this way. So yeah, it is very time consuming. Like why do teachers choose this way? Just to make the students think.
But is it acceptable in schools to use the silent trick?
It is if you feel it is suitable for the students. Sometimes, you know, they tend, like, you see, you're not spoon feeding the students.
Mm.
If we look at the Malaysian context teaching, the teachers write all the answers and then, you know, they fill in the blanks. So it means that they are giving the answers and then they are trying out. But if teachers is keeping quiet the whole class, they are basically cognitively thinking, helping them to think, helping them to like create formulate the hypothesis. They form their grammar rules. It's not the teacher is saying it.
Can I ask one last question?
Okay.
What
what about a big class of 40 students?
Yes, definitely it's going to be very, very time consuming for a bigger class. It is always depends on the teacher how she wants to do it. If it's a big classroom, maybe they break into groups. I think there should be teacher assistants to help in that sort. But this approach is very, very suitable for those who want to learn another language. Like for example, you don't know English, and then you come in, or example, when you learn phonetics. So they use this color chart to actually explain, you know, they use each sounds to say, so the teacher tend to, so they will use those words to actually learn another language. So that is more suitable than for a bigger, going into an advanced learning, it won't be that suitable.
How would you, let's say you have a baby with your child, how would you make him sit silently to just look at the board? Because in this method, if I can hear the teacher's voice, what I would think is, okay, my ears are hearing my voice in the teacher, so I can just do it. But here in this one, I have to see the teacher to get track of the lesson. So how does it work with that?
So like being like a special need, having a student with special needs in the class.
Not very special needs, but very naughty. Like if they say, what if a student is like always voicing out the answer, not the other ones? You know the ones which are very notorious, purposely they do. So
you keep them beside you. You keep them like near to you, and you have to. That's why you have always. That's why the teacher points. When the teacher points, and then only you answer. It's not. That's why they say you should. You know, when she was saying the classroom rules, you should keep quiet. That was the first rule that she mentioned. And do not play. You cannot ask your friend what was it. So it's not like helping out friends. And like you said, like those ADHD students, they keep saying things. They keep wanting to be. You know, they keep wanting to dominate the class. So that's why the teacher always point. Then only the student answer. If he doesn't. It won't, I mean, like, whenever the teacher points, the students are allowed to answer, something like that. So even the class would be silent.
What is the success rate of this model?
The success rate of this, it is like very, very, those students who are learning a new language, it is very successful. But if they already know the language and they're trying to get things like, you know, you know, actually basically we all know that on it. So when you construct the sentences, like the students already know what is on. So when they want to construct, it's like very easy for them. It is not so helpful for them, but going back to those who learn a new language is very, very successful because they tend to try one by one. To try, if I'm teaching French here now, so okay, let me go for Tamil. Then if I say and write word by word, then they will know it. Then they are not thinking for themselves. Mm-hmm. So like if these words, they are actually exploring themselves. For a new language, it is very, very successful. It shows, but for a higher level, it's not really. And it most research that we read, those articles that we're reading, it shows that. It is very, very challenging for the teachers.
So to add on your main point, because this approach is more focused on the fluency of the target language and the pronunciation and also the basic grammar of the language. So like when they learn, they won't really learn very deep of this target language.